Hello and welcome to my channel. Say hi to a happy day. In this channel, I would like to share tales and stories I personally picked and or my kids' favorite book stories. Let's enjoy listening while I read to you a story. Frog and Toad are friends. A lost button. Toad and Frog went for a walk. They walked across a large meadow. They walked in the woods. They walked along the river. At last, they went back home to Toad's house. "Oh, drat," said Toad. "Not only do my feet hurt, but I have lost one of the buttons on my jacket." "Don't worry," said Frog. "We will go back to all the places where we walked. We will soon find your button." They walked back to the large meadow. They began to look for the button in the tall grass. "Here is your button," cried Frog. "That is not my button," said Toad. "That button is black. My button was white." Toad put the black button in his pocket. A sparrow flew down. "Excuse me," said the sparrow. "Did you lose a button? I found one." "That is not my button," said Toad. "The button has two holes." "My button had four holes." Toad put the button with two holes in his pocket. They went back to the woods and looked on the dark paths. "Here is your button," said Frog. "That is not my button," cried Toad. "That button is small. My button was big." Toad put the small button in his pocket. A raccoon came out from behind a tree. "I heard that you were looking for a button," he said. "Here is one that I just found." "That is not my button," wailed Toad. "That button is square. My button was round." Toad put the square button in his pocket. Frog and Toad went back to the river. They looked for the button in the mud. "Here is your button," said Frog. "That is not my button," shouted Toad. "That button is thin." "My button was thick." Toad put the thin button on his pocket. He was very angry. He jumped up and down and screamed. "The whole world is covered with buttons, and not one of them is mine." Toad ran home and slammed the door. There on the floor, he saw his white, four-holed, big, round, thick button. "Oh," said Toad. "It was here all the time. What a lot of trouble I have made for Frog." Toad looked at all the buttons out of his pocket. He took his sewing box down from the shelf. Toad sewed the buttons all over his jacket. The next day, Toad gave his jacket to Frog. Frog thought that it was beautiful. He put it on and jumped for joy. None of the buttons fell off. Toad had sewed them on very carefully. The end. I hope you enjoy listening to Frog and Toad Are Friends, A Lost Button. Please don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to listen to more of our favorite book stories. See you soon!